Hello everyone, welcome to WebSense Pro. I'm your host Bilal Nasir with a new Shopify tutorial. And in today's tutorial, I'll teach you guys how you can move currency selector in DOM theme from footer to header. So I have received lots of comments in the other videos which I have created with you guys were requesting me to create a tutorial for you guys on how you can move currency selector from footer to header, because obviously it's much better for user to switch the currency when it's showing up on header. So if you want to learn how to move that, stick to the video. Don't forget to subscribe the channel. Without further ado, let's get into the code. So guys, that's how the currency selector will look like after moving from footer to header. That's the desktop mode. And now let's switch to the mobile version to see how it looks. So that's how it will look in mobile version. And that's how it will look in desktop version. You will also have the option to enable and disable it from customize settings. So you can enable and disable it. So when you go to your online editor, customize setting of your theme, you'll have this option under header. Scroll down to the bottom. You'll have this option to check and uncheck it. So once you uncheck it, the currency selector will be gone. And if you check it, you'll be able to see your currency selector here. Okay, now let's implement that. Now let's go to the Shopify backend where I have already added the fresh version of DOM, which is DOM 8.0. And that's our Shopify backend. After loading, click on online store. And from online store, as you can see, I have this activated version where I have already added the code. And that's the fresh version of DOM, which I have added just 8 minutes ago. Okay, now let's publish it. And now I'm going to add the code, which I have already prepared for you guys. Click on these three small dots and click on edit code. Before editing the code, make sure to have the duplicate of your theme. Because if you're working on a live version, you may add the code wrongly and you can mess up your theme. So that's good to have a backup so you can easily revert it back if you mess up anything. Now click on edit code. And in first step, we'll add the CSS code in our base.css file. Don't worry about the code. I'll be providing all of the code instructions within a blog post which you can find in YouTube video description. Now let's search for base.css file. Go all the way to the bottom and paste the CSS code which you will find in the blog post. Now click save. After that, let's move on to our second step. In our second step, we will open up header.liquid. And in header or liquid, the line number is 994. Okay, so that's the ending code. And that's the curly braces where you will add the code. Just copy this code and paste it here. Let's fix the format, add the line break. Make sure to not to miss this comma because that's the JSON format. If you miss this, your code's not gonna work. Now after pasting this code, hit save. After saving the file, make sure you have no error. If you're seeing a setting.json or red color error, you might have missed this comma or you're not placing this code properly. So make sure to place this code and save the file and make sure you don't have any error. Okay, now let's move on to our third step, which is again in header.liquid, we will add this code in line number 658 and it's above slash div and slash header. So let's search for slash header. There we are. And we will be placing above this div. So add another line break. And in line number 658, above slash div and slash header, add this code. So it's a huge code. So what I basically did is copied this code from the footer and replacing it to header. And I have done multiple tests in order to check if this code is working properly or not. So after pasting this, click on save. And after saving this, let's move on to our fourth step, which is again the code for header.liquid. And add this header.liquid, add this code below slash header. So that's our step four. So I'm going to copy this code. And place this code below slash header. After pasting this code, hit save. After saving this file, we'll search for global.js file, which is our final step of the tutorial. And in global.js, we'll add some JS code in order to make it loading smoothly. So scroll down all the way to the bottom and add the JS code, which is provided. I have this code here, which I'm just gonna copy and paste. After adding this code, hit save. And now we are done with our tutorial. Now let's preview the store to how our currency selector looks like. And here we go. That's how our currency selector looks like. And let's switch the currency to see if it's working. Okay, it's working fine. Let's check out the mobile version. Looks good on mobile version as well. And now let's check our customized setting options. Now exit and go to the customize, where we will test if we can enable and disable it from customize settings. So go to customize. And that's our currency selector. Click on header here. Scroll down, where you will see option to enable or disable country region selector. Just uncheck it, hit save. We can see that it's been removed from our preview. Let's check it in our store as well. And there we go. Our currency selector has been removed by unchecking this option in customized settings. Cool, right? Okay guys, that's it for the tutorial. Until next video, have a great day.